In today's video, we are going to go through three different tabs you can find in our configurator, all of which are in some way related to the SMS and call functionality of our devices. Let's start with the SMS call settings, where we can configure how the device will communicate with other mobile devices. First setting we will find here is SMS data sending. Some people think that once this setting is enabled, the device will start sending AVL data to the configured number, but that is not the case, unfortunately. This feature allows the device to send a binary data message in case the GPRS network is not available and a panic priority event occurs. It is a legacy feature, so for it to work, the receiving modem has to be able to receive and decode binary data, so configuring your mobile phone number here is not an option. Additionally, the operators also have to support this functionality, and because there are less and less users who are actually using this feature, the functionality is no longer maintained by some of the operators as well. Going forwards, we see the SMS commands section, where we can set up SMS login and password. These are really important to protect the device from unauthorized access. After SMS login and password is configured, they have to be used before each SMS command that is sent to the device by following this structure: SMS login space, SMS password space, and the actual command. Additionally, in this section, we can also configure the SMS event time zone, where we can configure our time zone that will be used in SMS responses and alerts. A common misconception is that this setting also changes the timestamp in the records, but the records to the server are always sent with GMT 0, UTC 0, time zone. Next setting I would like to talk about is authorized numbers list. Using this table, we can configure GSM numbers, which are able to make changes to the device configuration. If at least one number is entered in the list, only commands that are sent from that number will be executed. This is a very valuable security feature, as it limits the amount of people who are able to make change to the configuration, even if they would know the SMS login and password. Final setting in this tab is GSM numbers. Here, we can configure the GSM numbers that could be used for other functionalities. For example, the phone number entered here can then be selected in the overspeeding feature settings in order to send an SMS notification to this number. We can add up to 10 phone numbers here, which then can be selected separately for each feature. Next tab I am going to speak about today is SMS events. This tab was introduced together with the 29th base firmware, allowing the users to configure various SMS events by just selecting the AVL ID of an event, GSM number that the SMS should be sent to, and SMS text to be included in the SMS message. This is useful in case you want to get notified about certain events that you can configure in the IO, CAN, OBD, and other tabs. The AVL ID that you would need to enter here can be found on our wiki page. Finally, the last tab I would like to discuss is the GSM operators, where we can configure how the device will identify various operators. The first thing you will see in this tab is the roaming operator list, where we configure the operators that are preferable if the home operator is not available. We can enter up to 50 operator IDs here, and if the device would connect to one of them, the device will automatically switch to roaming profile, changing the data acquisition frequency according to the settings set in the data acquisition tab. Another important setting we see here is the operator's blacklist. Here we can configure operators which should be avoided by the device. These operators are usually the ones who charge high roaming costs, so in order to avoid that, we can add them to the operator blacklist. However, even if the operator is listed in the blacklist, the device will still connect to this operator if no other operators are available. Once connected to such operator, the device will disable the data sending function and will start storing all records in the internal memory, but the device would still be reachable via SMS commands and calls, allowing to still monitor the vehicle location and make any changes needed to the device configuration.